51 people died when the sand dredger Bow Bell ploughed into the Marchioness last August. Since the tragedy, pleasure boat operators have been urged to improve voluntary safety procedures in advance of new regulations coming into force this month.
But with the new season just beginning, Thames News has discovered that those procedures are still being ignored by boat operators. And some of the 90 boats that are licensed to carry passengers on the Thames have what one marine expert has described as serious flaws in safety measures.
Captain Eric Beetham is an independent marine expert who was a ship's master for 20 years. He accompanied a Thames film crew posing as tourists aboard three pleasure boats, the Mercedes, Valula and Hollywood. We discovered that in the event of an emergency, passengers on all three boats would have difficulty in getting off. On the Hollywood, licensed to carry 297 passengers, exit doors were locked with no keys nearby to open them. The key to open this door was hidden behind a loudspeaker, and Captain Beetham describes how a passenger would have to open an emergency window.
The instructions up here tell you to take the hammer, you smash the glass up there, you get a key, and you have to open three locks in the bottom. Not the visible locks in the aluminium window, but in the red frame at the bottom. You then push the frame through, and you're meant to support it with a stay at the side.
That took him 18 seconds to explain. The Marchioness sank in less than 30. Following guidelines issued by the Transport Secretary Cecil Parkinson, passengers boarding the Mercedes were counted, with the number left ashore. We did not see this happen on the two other boats. But the crew of the Mercedes then failed to give adequate instructions to passengers on emergency exits and procedures. Another guideline issued by Mr. Parkinson. The main passenger door was also locked, and windows on the lower deck could only be opened with a special handle not readily available to passengers. The only safety announcement made on the Valula was that in the event of an emergency, passengers should stay calm and wait for further instructions.
Well, this concludes the guided part of the trip today, ladies.
On the three boats, we also found emergency exits blocked, signs obscured, and unsecured fire extinguishers.
I'm appalled. We expected when we went out to find the occasional minor breach of the recommendations or regulations, but three boats, all with major deficiencies, is quite remarkable.
If those three boats had been the Marchioness, how many people on those three boats would have gone out on that night?
Less than a third or a quarter, I would say.
Do you think we have learnt our lessons from the last disaster?
No, I don't.
The boat operators' organisations say their regulations are under constant review, but they admit that passengers should be able to open exit doors at all times.
We've got to look to a safety glass method where a key is kept by the door in a safety glass that you can smash in the case of emergency, and some vessels already have that.
Diogo de Vasconcelos lost both of his brothers on the Marchioness, the boat hired to celebrate one of their birthdays.
We've had assurances by the Transport Secretary that changes will be brought about by the independent reports, and your film is going to show that those assurances weren't in fact true, and so the only way in our eyes is to have a full public inquiry.
The three boats we saw have all been licensed by the Department of Transport and were breaking no laws, and boat owners also met the department last week to discuss improved training for crews. Tonight the department welcomed any reports of discrepancies on boats but didn't accept that all doors and windows should serve as emergency exits. But they said our findings on passenger counts would constitute an offence once the new regulations are in force. Ken Andrew, Thames News.